Well, this is going to be a demonstration on what I have been doing here. It's going to be real fun. Actually, you may feel like it's working on an assembly line, which it pretty much is. We've got a Bunsen burner going over here. If you can see the flame, that's to try to keep the other microbes off. We have the solution here that I'm going to be transferring into these tiny little tubes. Hopefully, I have done them. So we're going to do five. I have taken others and filled them. These are 5 milliliter tubes, and as you can see, this is just with a solution. We'll later put the yeast into it that we hope will grow. Yeast from California, by the way. So, what we do is this is a 10 milliliter pipette. We go through a lot of these. These actually have to be carefully processed afterwards in case they have any nasty bugs on them. So I'm turning it so that I can see here, and I'm going to take 4 milliliters up to there, we hope. All right, so it's really important that you keep these things sterile. So this has been processed, so it is sterile. The foil on top is sterile, and I have to get in very quickly and get it. And you'll see basically how fun this is to do. So I'm taking up 4 milliliters, which is about this. It doesn't have to be exact. I take off the top and I empty it, except I already filled that one. That's not good. So these things happen. Start again with the next two. I already filled all of these. That was bad of me.
That's good.
Well, it's good, but I have the, let's see, these are the 20 degrees and I need 30 degrees. My bad. This happens. So we'll make sure that this is, all right, we're ready to go. Here's the 20 degrees. This is why you always have to check and double check.
Or else you overflow your tubes like we did that once.
Oh. And if you squirt too fast, you overflow them, and here's the problem about
it's like a water
pipe. Having loosened it. There we go. That goes in. So, as you can see, this is really like being on an assembly line. Do we even have assembly lines in America anymore? I don't know.
Maybe. It's probably not. Like
sometimes you have to just unscrew it and put it like that. I guess that's the closest one to doing it. You got to be careful that you're not touching anything here. Later on, we will actually put the real stuff in. I've gone through and loosened these, but sometimes they tighten themselves.
So, Joe, how many do you think you're doing today?
I can tell you exactly. I'm doing 64 and 2 negative controls. Negative control is we just put the solution in, and we don't have anything growing in it. So this is a negative solution, or negative control, and we will not put any yeast in that. If we start seeing bubbling or growth or things like that, it means that everything has been contaminated. I stopped after filling the first pipette. I used a pipette to fill this one. This one is at 20 degrees. We're now doing ones that will be incubated, is that the right term?
Yep.
At 30 degrees.
Awesome.
And this is the assembly line and the Hidinger yeast lab.
Part one.